Hello dear friends, this is Dr. Mohammad Aminulchem. Welcome to my channel. In my previous video, I showed how to determine point of zero charge. In this video, I will show you how to carry out point of zero charge determination experiment by Zetapotential measurement. This experiment is very important, so please do not skip. The pH at which the net total particle charge is zero, that is when zeta potential vanishes or zero, is called point of zero charge. So we use dynamic light scattering by direct assessment of surface charges via non-specific ion adsorption as a function of pH and point of net charge, measuring zeta potential for manganese dioxide suspension. So here is the experimental setup for dynamic light scattering, which is connected to a desktop. Now, procedure. This procedure is reproducible, so new researcher can follow this and determine point of zero charge. In the beginning, several polyethylene flasks of 50 milliliter were taken and leveled. Then 0.01 gram of solid manganese dioxide powder was taken into each of the flask. Then by burette, 50 milliliter of 0.01 molar potassium nitrate was added to each of the flask to make suspension. Then pH was adjusted with pH meter using 0.1 molar sodium hydroxide and 0.1 molar hydrochloric acid to initial pH, for example 1.5, 3, 6, 7, 9 and 10. Then the flask was shaken thoroughly for 24 hours by means of a orbital shaker. Then the pH was recorded after allowing the solutions to equilibrate for 24 hours. Then the supernatant liquid of each of the flasks were collected and labeled Falcon tubes. Zeta potential was measured at 25 degrees Celsius using 760 microliter supernatant into the sample cuvette, and corresponding data was recorded. So here is the measurement setup. For example, our sample was manganese dioxide, so refractive index was this, ABS was this, model was this, and temperature was 25 degrees Celsius, and we used green disposable zeta cell. This percent was water, and back scatter angle 173 degrees, and sample volume was 760 microliter. Then here is the electrophoretic mobility distribution for manganese dioxide. Then here is the zeta potential distribution. Then results. Here is the number of sample, then initial pH, then final pH after equilibration for 24 hours. Then zeta potential millivolt. Then this data was plotted, and here is the zeta potential versus pH curve. So from this curve, it is seen that the zeta potential was zero at pH 2.5. Therefore, the point of zero charge for manganese dioxide was 2.5. So this is how we can easily carry out a zeta potential measurement experiment for the determination of point of zero charge. Thanks for watching.